Sales and Marketing for Caetano Kenya.
Salvador Caetano Group is the sole distributor and retailer of Hyundai and Renault passenger vehicles in the Kenyan market. The company offers distribution and retail of new vehicles and after-sales services. Michael De Souza is the GM for sales and marketing for Caetano Kenya. He has previously worked for Samia Africa, Airtel, Gulf African Bank and DTB, while continuing his DJ performances part-time. Thank you so much for giving us this opportunity. We really appreciate. So how exactly has coronavirus affected the automobiles market?
The COVID-19, I think, has had a very negative effect on industries around the world, and the automotive industry has not been spared. Unfortunately, around the world, a lot of manufacturing plants have had to shut down for a while. They have started reopening, and of course, people have been looking at essential purchases. Initially, when we were coming off the initial months like Feb, March, the industry took a serious dive, but that has shown signs of picking up.
Have you seen a shift in consumer behavior?
Yes, I would say in the last couple of months, whether customers want to just enjoy life, given that the risks that we are living with, or just the requirements that they had in the earlier months that have resulted in them not purchasing cars. I'm proud to say for us, this month is looking like a very good month for us, and I think that that's a positive sign. It has shown an upward trend for the last couple of months, so we are obviously very excited about that.
So what exactly have you learned from that experience?
What we have learned, I think, as a company is that how we need to adapt. So gone are the days that you could have events at malls or open days at your facilities to drive traffic in. What we're doing a lot of advertising and trying to reach out to our customers through social platforms. And then as and when the need requires, we will take our beautiful vehicles to the customer, to his office, to his workplace, of course, with a sanitization kit so that when we're handing over a vehicle for a test drive, we sanitize and, you know, keep the car ready and keep everyone as safe as possible. But I think overall it's taking what we knew for granted and just learning to live with a new norm that is what we're going through right now.
So as a leader, what was the most difficult part about your job?
I guess being in a sales frontline position, a lot of people have had the opportunity to work from home, my wife included. So in our job, I don't think we can work from home because we're selling a product that somebody has got to touch and feel. Yeah. Then we've got servicing to do. So you bring your car in, we can't do that remotely while you're sitting at home. So trying to ensure that we keep our staff safe, we keep our customers safe, because a customer coming in, you don't know where he's come from, where he or she has been prior to getting there. But also the staff, the movements of them coming in and out of the office, there is a high risk. So we've been following the guidelines and just making sure that everybody wears our masks, everybody sanitizes in and out. We check our temperatures every day and keep a record of it. And, you know, just try and do everything that you can do. Life must go on. Businesses must run. I mean, there's some countries that when it went into total lockdown where a lot of people lost their jobs. I think quite a few Kenyans have lost their jobs as well, which is a shame. But just trying to keep that balance so that we can keep the business alive. You know, we've put a lot of investment into the business in Kenya, and I think just trying to keep a balance to keep our staff healthy, keep our customers healthy, and keep everyone mobile on the road.
What will drive automobile demand in 2021?
Manufacturing is a very expensive investment, and I think if the volumes can support it, then a lot more assemblers would come in, not only as assembly but as full manufacturing. And once the regulation changes to accommodate that, then I think we would have a lot more investments. I think also new vehicles have a lot of advantages for the local consumer. You get the local warranty, you're buying a brand new car. So if anything goes wrong, and remember, cars are made up of different components, and I don't think anybody out there makes a bad car. So we've got a lot of competition, but our competition is unique. It's not only me competing with other new vehicles in Kenya. We're competing with also the grey market dealers who are importing new-ish and old vehicles. Now, for the Kenyan consumer, the taxes and the cost, the landed cost of an eight-year-old car are a lot cheaper in comparison to what we are selling, being a brand new product. So that again comes with its own risk. There'll be higher wear and tear costs, maintenance costs. So I think it's a fine balance of what regulation will put in store for us that could change the industry for us.
So do you drive other automobiles or you just stick to Renault and Hyundai?
I am fortunate enough to be able to drive any of our vehicles. So my wife doesn't yet drive one of my vehicles because where I was working previously, we bought a car for her from there. So that car is only 2 years old. His name is Kenzo. We name our cars. They become part of the family. So my kids name our cars as well. But I'm hoping fairly soon we have a new, very exciting model, the Hyundai Palisade, coming out early next year. And I'm hoping, God willing, that I'll be able to put my wife in one very soon.